Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Let's see how many people we have. We have 7 people here in the class.
Hello.
Hello, Pedrina. Hi, everyone. Nice to see you today.
Good evening.
Good evening. Hi, Maria. Hi, Maria's daughter.
Hello.
Hello, Amilcar. Hello, Celia. Hi, Emerson.
Hi, Abigail.
Okay, so we're going to start with today's class, and this is going to be very easy to practice today. We're going to continue working with the useful email phrases, okay? But let's wait for more people. Let's wait one more minute for everyone else to come here. Esperemos para que se unan un par más, porque vamos a seguir con las expresiones del correo que estábamos viendo ayer. Y no quiero que muchos se queden atrás. Y solo hay 8 de los 17. Let's wait 2 more minutes, okay? So we can start. Let me show you my computer. Démosles un minutito más.
Teacher, I can listen to you.
You listen to me now?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, good. Okay, good. Let's start then. We have 12 people now. We're going to start with the second class, so welcome again, right? We're going to start here, and I would like to remember that we have to put our full names when we access Zoom Pro, right? We have to keep our cameras on all the time. In that I am going to take attendance 3 times during the class, okay? At 8:10, 9 p.m., and at the end of the class. And well, let's start. We are in unit 1. Carmen, can you please read the first competency?
Describe regular activities in the workplace.
Very good, thank you so much. Go with number two, Emerson. Emerson, go with number two.
Describe everyday situation.
Situations, very good. Let's go with number three. Please work with me, Maria. Identify.
Identify requests for specific personal finance information.
Very good. Roxana, go with number four. Talk about.
Talk about financial information and work perks.
And work perks, very good. Okay. Let's go, Azalia, with the last one. Scan specific information. Your microphone.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Scan specific information field in an informative document.
Okay, very good. We're going to scan a specific information. A scan is read, okay? Vamos a leer, very good. Now, like we said, we are in video conferencia número dos, right? It's time expressions for regular activities. That's what we're going to do. And well, in this case, first, I want you to mention three activities you can do in your workplace every day. Let's go ahead and mention three activities that you can do in your workplace every day. Let's start with Ana Gabriela. No, Ana Gabriela was not here yesterday. Let's start with Roxana. You're the lucky one, Roxana. Mention three activities that you can do in your workplace every day.
I can read. Okay. I can type in the computer.
I can type in the computer. Okay.
I can watch videos, information videos. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I can watch information videos. Okay, very good. Tell me three activities that you do every day in your workplace, Carmen.
I make calls to my providers. I read a report too.
Okay.
And I attend a meeting too.
I attend meetings too, very good. Sandra Gladys, tell me the activities that you do in your workplace.
Make reports, check emails. Type in computer in a conta.
Okay, very good, very good. You type in the computer financial reports. Financial reports. Okay, very good. And Pedrina, tell me the activities that you do on your workplace.
I supervisor a call center, a report caja. Esa palabra, teacher, se me confunde bastante cómo decirla en inglés.
What do you do in Spanish?
Chequeo los reportes de, en la mañana cuando llego, chequeo los reportes de caja.
I check the financial reports.
I check
the financial reports. Look at the chat, Pedrina. I check the financial report. Okay. Look at the chat. Miren el chat la respuesta. Ahí está. I check the financial reports.
I check the financial reports.
Very good. Tell me, Daniela Milcar, what do you do every day on your workplace? Tell me three activities.
I send email address. X-ray scan, habit, transport.
Okay. I send emails. That's one. What is the next one you send? What's number two?
Scan, no, X-ray scan, heavy transport.
Oh, I scan heavy transport. Okay. I scan heavy transport. Okay, very good.
Yes.
Very good. Remember, in the chat, I am going to put phrases, vocabulary, cualquier frase nueva, cualquier vocabulario que estemos pronunciando, que yo identifique que es nuevo, lo voy a poner en el chat, apúntenlo de ahí, ¿ok? Apúntenlo de ahí. Now, we have this for yesterday's class, but also we practice with some of the useful email phrases, right? We've practiced number one, right? With number one, we practice with please find attach. Please find attach this week report. Please find attach my resume. Please find attach the monthly sales report. What's another example that you can write here? Please find attach what? What's another example? ¿Qué documentos envíen?
For example, please find attach my certificate.
Excellent, that's perfect. Please find attach my certificate. Very good, that's great.
Please find attach taxes.
Okay, that's great. Please find attach the taxes. Excellent job, Sandra. What's another example?
I send sales reports.
Okay, so Azalia, please find attach the sales report. Repeat.
No. Sí, estoy oyendo.
Repeat, please.
Azalia, please find attach the sales report.
The sales report.
Please find attach the sales report.
Please find attach the same report.
Sales report. Very good. Now, yes?
Teacher, can be... Please find attach the new English book.
Yes, yes, that is correct. That is correct. In this case, the English book, it will be a file in your computer, right? It's a file. Cualquier archivo en su computadora puede attach. Please find attach the photos from my birthday. Please find attach the photos of the meeting. Right?
Yes.
Oh. Very good. Now let's go with number two. We practiced yesterday number two. I have forwarded the documents to you. I am forwarding the documents to you. Right? What else can we say? I am forwarding the photos to you. I am forwarding the email to you. I am forwarding the certificate to you. Right? What's another example that we can write here? Remember that they have the same definition, the same meaning. What's another example? Tell me another example.
Uh-huh.
I'm forwarding the letter to you. Very good, Sandrita. I am forwarding the letter to you. Excellent job. I am forwarding the letter to you. What's another example here, Abigail? Let us think about the documents that you work with every day. Recordemos todos los documentos con los que trabajamos todos los días. Okay. I am forwarding the letter to you. What else? What other type of document do you receive?
Report the sales.
Okay, I am forwarding, okay, the sales reports.
The sales reports
to you. Very good. Right, very good. So these are examples of what you're going to use with forward. Now, let's go, well, let's make a small pause. I am going to call the attendance because it's 8:15. Vamos a esperar un ratico. Le voy a pasar la asistencia súper rápido. Súper rápido, me van a sentir. Give me a moment. Let's see. Open your cameras, please. Open your cameras. Celia, Ricardo, Alexis, please open your cameras. Encienda sus cámaras, por favor. Very good. We start with the attendance. Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayoa. Ana Gabriela.
I'm here.
Thank you, Ana Gabriela. Ángela de Jesús Santa María. Azalea Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Present, teacher.
Carmen Elizabeth Hernández Escobar.
Present.
Celia Jazmín Castro de Chévez.
Present.
Daniela Mirka Sandoval Avilés.
Present.
Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present.
Glenda Esmeralda Trigueros Vázquez. José Alfonso Palma Mejía. Juan Josué Hernández Hernández. Leida Susana Sorto Cuadra. Luis Armando Ventura Campos. María Concepción Cerón Jovel.
Present.
Pedrina Iliana Gómez Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Alexis Fuentes Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Gabriel Varenga Ventura. Roxana Yanira Mengíbar Escobar.
Present.
Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Present, teacher.
Jennifer Abidail López Escoto.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. So let's continue. We were working with the third useful expression for emails. Right? In this one, is when we put someone else in our email. Right? This is when we put someone else in our email. So what does this mean? It means that I want to send the email to Roxana, but I also copy Sandra, so Sandra can see the email, right? So in this case, I have copied Gabriel, so Gabriel can see the email that I am writing to, right? He's going to see that information as well. Now, let's go ahead and practice here. This phrase, to keep him on the loop, to keep him in the loop, is it means that the person is going to pay attention to the email and is going to be taking care of all the information. Okay? Cuando estamos hablando de lenguaje corporativo, right? Business information, we need to make sure that we are putting right here, someone that needs to pay attention. For example, if I am sending an email to my supervisor, I will say, I have copied Elena on this email to keep her in the loop. So I am going to come here, right? And I am going to copy Elena, right? To keep her in the loop. So she is aware of the email. Entonces ella sabe que yo estoy enviando ese email a una persona, right? Ella va a ser como mi punto de evidencia hasta cierto punto. Cuando estamos trabajando, siempre tenemos que tener a alguien que nos respalde que nosotros hemos hecho un trabajo. Al menos en los Estados Unidos así se hace. Si usted envía un correo, usted tiene que tener el respaldo de que alguien más también recibió ese correo por cualquier inconveniente. For any inconvenience, you need to make aware another person that you have sent that email. In this case, I am making her aware to keep her in the loop. Right? ¿Entendemos esta frase? To keep her in the loop?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. What about the others? Yes? Okay. Let's continue. Let's continue. I am going to continue sharing here my computer. We're going to go with phrase number four. In phrase number four, it says, if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. Okay. Please don't hesitate to contact me. Now, hesitate means wait. Okay. That is the meaning of hesitate. Hesitate means wait. Wait. Carmen, don't hesitate. Don't wait. Okay. When I say don't hesitate, it means don't wait. So in the classes, I can tell you, guys, don't worry, don't hesitate. Ask me questions, right? No se preocupen. No esperen a que yo les pregunte. Ustedes pregúntenme a mí, right? Don't hesitate means don't wait. Is this part clear? Is this part clear? If you have any questions, right? If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. Esto siempre lo vamos a utilizar okay. Al final de un mensaje, al mensaje de un correo, al final de un correo electrónico, to make the doors open for the other person, right? In case that they don't understand the email that you're sending. En caso que la persona no entienda qué está enviando, por qué lo está enviando, o qué envió, o usted envió un relajo, right? So you say, if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. If you have any questions, maybe about my resume. Remember, we have my resume here, right? Please don't hesitate to contact me. Is this part clear? Is this part clear? ¿Se entiende? Yeah. ¿Se entiende que es hesitate?
Yes.
Yes, yes, teacher.
Okay. Le voy a creer. Ya le voy a preguntar yo. Now, let's go with the next one and the last one actually. Is I look forward to. I look forward to. In this case, what we're going to do is that we're going to put at the end of the email, we're going to put this phrase. And this is a phrase that we need to be very careful with, right? In English, usually when we have the preposition to, the verb is going to be in the base form, right? I need to call you. I have to wake up early. I have to prepare my breakfast, right? That is usually what we do. Usualmente, siempre después de la preposición to, utilizamos el verbo en su forma base, como call, swim, prepare, right? Pero en este caso no, porque ya es, como decía ayer Gabriel, es una frase hecha. Right? Es una frase que ya está hecha. So what are we going to do? It says, I look forward to hearing from you. We can put this. I look forward to hearing from you. I look forward to meeting you. I look forward to your reply. These are three options that you can use. I look forward to seeing you. To seeing you, for example. Si es un verbo, siempre va a ir con ing. Okay? Si es un nombre, un sustantivo, un object pronoun, lo va a escribir normal. I look forward to your reply. I look forward to meeting you. I look forward to seeing you. I look forward to speaking to you. Right? to speaking to you. That's what we're going to use. That's what we're going to use every time that we have look forward to. Look forward to. Right? These are the options. Now, at the end of the email, we are going to write kind regards, warm wishes, regards, yours truly. Es como cuando decimos en español, saludos cordiales, hasta pronto, hasta luego. Bueno, yo solo escribo saludos cordiales, no sé qué escribirán ustedes. Right? Hasta pronto, un placer, atentamente, right? Kind regards, warm wishes, yours truly, right? That's what we're going to do. So let's go ahead and copy these phrases. We're going to put them in our email, right? We go here and we put them here at the end, right? I look forward to hearing from you, right? Kind regards, Sylvia Ramos, right? So this is going to be my email. Right, I am going to send this email to Sylvia and I am going to CC Elena, right? So she can be in the loop for this email as well, right? Do you have a question about how to send emails or the important phrases for emails? ¿Alguna pregunta? Then we click on send, right? Pero no lo voy a enviar. Naughty. Do you have questions?
Teacher.
Yes.
No mucho comprendí porque en realidad no sé qué significa todo eso. Algunas palabras sí las entiendo, pero lo demás sí no. Si cree que me lo podría decir en español para tratar de entenderlo.
Okay. Now.
Please.
We're going to look for phrases here, Ricardo. Okay, esta frase, please find attached. Please find attached this will report, my resume, the math research reports. Va a ocupar la frase, please find attached, más el documento que va a enviar cuando usted está adjuntando un documento. Okay, please find attached. Please find attached my resume, my photos, my seminar information, right? Cualquier documento que usted tenga en su computadora puede ser un attachment. Okay. Entonces usted va a utilizar attach. Ahora, esa es la primera. La segunda. I have forwarded the documents to you or I am forwarding the documents to you. Es la frase que vamos a utilizar cuando reenviamos correos electrónicos. Okay. Yo recibo un correo y le voy a reenviar este correo a alguien más porque necesita verlo en el trabajo, right? You're going to use this phrase. I am forwarding the documents to you. I am forwarding the letter to you. I am forwarding the sales reports to you. Lo que le va a cambiar usted acá es el que va a reenviar. Okay? Eso es lo que va a cambiar. Por eso hay diferentes opciones acá. Luego, tenemos, I have copied Gabriel on this email to keep him in the loop. Copied es cuando usted envía un correo, pero también yo le envío un correo a mi supervisora, pero también quiero que mi jefe sepa que estoy enviando ese correo. Entonces yo le envío el correo a mi supervisora y copio a mi jefe en el correo para que él vea que yo ya hice algo que estaba relacionado con el trabajo. Así él está consciente. To keep him in the loop, consciente de la labor que yo estoy haciendo. Okay? To keep him in the loop. Luego, la número cuatro, si usted tiene alguna pregunta, no espere o no, no sería espere en español. No dude en consultarme o no dude en contactarme. Si tiene alguna pregunta, por favor, no dude en contactarme. That would be this. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. And the last one is, I look forward to hearing from you. Ya estamos hablando de la despedida del correo. Es cuando se dice, espero que me respondas ese mensaje, espero escuchar muy pronto de usted. En español decimos, quedo a la espera de sus comentarios, por ejemplo. Quedo a la espera de su respuesta. I look forward to hearing from you. Kind regards, warm wishes, regards, and yours truly. Significaría saludos, saludos cordiales, un abrazo, atentamente. Ya cuando nos estamos despidiendo del correo. Luego, we send it. We send the email. Right? Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. So now, I am going to ask you questions right now, and this is for everyone. I am going to show you here some questions, and I need you to pay attention, okay? I am going to give you a few seconds for you to look at the question, and then you're going to answer this to me. First question. I have here. Le voy a hacer preguntas de todo lo que les acabo de decir del useful email expressions. I look forward. What is the best answer? To hearing, to hear, hearing you, to hearing from you.
To hearing from you.
To hearing from you.
To hearing from you. Very good. The last one is the best answer. Please take a screenshot so you remember. Right? Take a screenshot so you can remember. Okay? That would be the best one. I look forward to hearing from you. Take the screenshot. Next question. Read this. Oh, sorry. Oh, what is this? Awful. I look forward to meet you. Is this sentence correct? Yes or no? I look forward to meet you. Tell me if yes. This sentence is correct. Is correct?
No.
No.
No, no for me.
It is not correct. Very good. Solo que no. Okay. It is not correct. Very good. What is the correct answer, Celia?
Meeting.
Okay. I look forward to meeting you. Very good. I look forward to meeting you. Excellent job. I look forward to meeting you. Now, let's question. Next question. Next question. I am forwarding John's response.
June.
You. At you, from you, to you, on you. No, no está bien.
To you.
To you, very good. I am forwarding John's response to you. Very good job, very good job. To you. Tomen screenshots, vamos rápido por cuestión de tiempo. ¿Ya tomaron screenshot?
Yes.
Okay. Let's continue. What is an attachment? Let me ask you this. I'm going to ask a specific people, okay? Vamos a hacerlo más entretenido. I'm going to ask a specific people. What is an attachment, Daniela Milka? Look at the answers. Read the possible answers. Daniela Milka Sandoval.
Sensory reward and key rewards are an example of attachment.
Is that an attachment? Sincere regards and kind regards are all examples of attachment.
Computer file.
What, Sandra Gladys?
A computer file that is as.
Very good. That is added to an email. That is correct. Daniela Mirkel, please write the answer. Escriba la respuesta. What is an attachment? A computer file that is added to an email. Okay. Quiere decir que si yo voy a mi correo electrónico, okay, I go to my email, Daniel, I am going to, look at this, even in the email says attach files. So I click here, I look for a file, right? I look for a file, I click on open, and I attach the file, right? That is an attachment. Is it clear, Daniel? Yes, okay. Very good. Thank you, Sandra. Let's go with the next question. Next question here. Let me, what is forward? And let me ask you this. Celia Jasmine, what is a forward? Esto es importante para todos nosotros, chicos. What is a forward?
A computer file? Adding to an email?
No, my friend. That is an attachment.
It is the last one.
It's resting to different address.
Okay.
It is the last one.
Yes. An email that is resent to a different address. Okay. An email that is resent to a different address. So I go here to my email, for example. I will go to my email. Can you see my computer? Can you see my computer? I have received this email. It's a nueva vacante, profesor. Okay, what I want to do is that I am going to forward this email, right, to someone else. So I'm gonna go here, right? And it says here on the email, forward, right? So I go here and I'm gonna send it to Carolina Castro, right? I don't know who Carolina is. So I go to Carolina and I will send it to Carolina, right? That means forward. Carolina is going to receive the same email. Okay. Estoy enviando este email a Carolina para que ella reciba el mismo correo electrónico que yo recibí. Right? That's what I want to do. I am sending, I am resending this email. Is that part clear? Is this part clear? Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Maybe. Okay, very good. Yes, let's teacher. Continue. Let's continue. Remember, attachment, a computer file added to an email. Forward, an email that is resent to a different address. Let's see next question. Angie, what is the best answer, Angie? If you have any question, please. We have different answers, Angela.
Okay, if you have a question, please. ¿Cómo se pronunciaría la primera teacher?
Hesitate.
Contact me. Perdón. Okay.
Hesitate.
Hesitate to contact me.
Okay. Now, what is the meaning of hesitate? Angela? No. What is the meaning of hesitate? Angela?
If you have any question, si tiene preguntas, ¿verdad?
No, no le estoy preguntando la traducción. ¿Cuál es el significado?
No, no, no. Lo que. No, no sé, teacher, sinceramente.
¿Cómo no? ¿Se acuerda? Yo sé que se acuerda. ¿Recuérdese? Hesitate. Hesitate means
wait.
What?
Wait.
Ah, wait.
Wait. Okay. Wait. Y si usted le dice, please hesitate to contact me, ¿no la van a contactar? ¿No la van a contactar? Porque usted okay. Le está diciendo, pensalo, no me contactes. Ajá. Ajá. ¿Cuál sería entonces la mejor opción, Angie?
No.
Aquí queremos hacer lo opuesto, a esperar.
Do not hesitate to
contact me. Don't hesitate to contact me. Very good.
Don't hesitate to contact me.
Ya ve que sí sabe.
Okay.
If you have any questions, please.
Wait, o sea.
Don't hesitate to contact me. Así todos lo van a escribir, así, ella me va a ayudar. Right? If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. María Concepción, you go next. Pay attention. I have CC'd one meal on this email. What is the answer? One meal will also receive the email even though it is not addressed to him. The email is addressed to Wang Min. Wang Min sent that email. I have saved Wang Min in my contact list. Wang Min es un nombre, okay? Es como que dijera, I have CC Jennifer Abigail.
I have so many in my contact list.
One more time.
I have some.
Wang Min in my contact list.
Yes.
No, not that one, not that one, Maria. Remember, CC means copy it. Look at what I'm going to do right here, okay? Wow. Look at my email, Maria, and let's see. Let's go to the draft. Okay. I got here the draft, okay, that I am going to send. This email is to Silvia Ramos. I am going to send it to another Silvia, not me, otra Silvia Ramos, okay? And I am going to CC, in this case, Solis, Jonathan Solis, okay? So I want to keep him, I want to keep Jonathan, right, on the loop, to keep him on the loop. This email is not to Jonathan. This email is to Sylvia, but I have copied Jonathan so he can pay attention to my email. Then I send it, right? So Maria, what is the answer?
One meal will also receive.
Excellent job. One meal will also receive the email, even though it is not addressed to him. Él va a recibir el correo electrónico, aunque no está dirigido a él. Él lo va a recibir y lo va a ver. Ah, que ellos dos están contactando. Right?
Teacher.
Yes.
Es como un respaldo, creo yo, ¿verdad?
Exactly. Esa vaca. Uh-huh. Vaca. Uh-huh. Un respaldo, vamos a decirlo en inglés, vaca. Let me put it here. Backup. Un vaca. It's a backup. Ustedes se cubren las espaldas en el trabajo. ¿Tienen qué? Por cualquier cosa, dice mi mamá. Right? So it's a backup. Now, do we understand, CC? Yes? Remember, CC is copied.
No me queda claro como la pregunta, digamos. Sí, sí, Wang Min es persona, entonces.
Wang Min es una persona. Yo puedo decir, I have CC Sandra copy. Gladys on this email.
Okay.
Sandra Gladys will also receive the email even though it is not addressed to her. The email is addressed to Sandra Gladys. Sandra Gladys sent the email. Wang Min es solo un nombre.
Ok.
Pero son nombres. Recuérdense que en Estados Unidos existen nombres, a lot of weird names. Hay nombres rarísimos que usted va a decir, ¿qué dijo? Right? Can you spell that for me? Right? Me lo deletrea porque no lo entendí. Right?
¿Cuál sería la respuesta correcta?
Number one. Wow. Yes. Eso lo dijo María y está correcto. Number one.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Let's go with number 19, right? Abigail. Kind regards. regards, good regards, and sincerely are all common ways to say, to end an email, yes or no. Levante ahí la manita de Zoom para ver su respuesta porque su micro no le sirve. Kind regards, regards, good regards, and sincerely are all common ways to end an email. Yes, that is correct. Very good, Jennifer Abigail. Yes, at the end of the email, you are going to put that. For example, here, I put kind regards. Kind regards and your name. Kind regards, Carmen said. Kind regards, Pedrina Ileana. Kind regards, Ricardo. Kind regards, Gabriel, right? Depending on your name. You can put warm regards. Eso es el, la despedida, dependerá de qué también se lleven ustedes con las personas. Yours truly, right? Este yours truly es como para más de amigos, más amigable. Okay? Más amigable. Siempre hay alguien con que ustedes se lleven más, ese es el más amigable. Yours truly. Okay. Now, do we understand useful expressions for emails?
Yes.
¿Entienden? Yes. Okay. Let's see the last one. I want you to help me out with the last one, Emerson. Emerson Javier, he says, please attach my resume. We have several options. Forward, find, examine, look at, PDF, Word doc. What's forward. The answer? Please forward attach my resume. What is the meaning of forward? Emerson? Can we say, please forward attach my resume? Luis Armando, what do you have? Please help Emerson. What could be the best answer?
I don't know, teacher.
Equivoquémonos, no hay problema.
Look.
Ya podemos equivocar. Forward es para reenviar, es correcto.
Puede look ser at. Look at.
Look at. Look at. Please look at or. Attach my
please
resume.
Look at attach my resume.
Mm-hmm.
For time.
Mm-hmm. I need you to go to the phrase number one. La primera frase que practicamos. Go check your notebook.
Please find attach my resume.
Please find attach my resume. Find. Mm. Please find attach my resume. Please find attach my resume. Yes, please find attach. Ya es una frase hecha. Please find attach. Miren sus apuntes y ahí lo van a ver. Please find attach my resume. Very good. And, well, we finished that with useful expressions for emails. Do you have questions about the useful expressions?
Todo esto está en el libro, teacher.
Somehow, yes. Somehow. It is pretty much on the link. But these are phrases that you're going to use.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. No está en, en los ejercicios del libro, pero sí está en el libro. Si ustedes revisan todos los ejercicios que vienen para el internet, ustedes los van a encontrar ahí también. Okay? Any questions about this? alguna pregunta, algo que no haya entendido, que quieren que les explique de nuevo? No. Sí, yes, maybe. No.
I think so, teacher, we have to practice that.
And the only way is by practicing and writing an email. Yeah. That's what we're going to do later today. Okay? We're going to do that later. Now, we're going to use the phrases. Okay? Si piensan trabajar en un ambiente donde hablen solo inglés, tienen que utilizar estas frases. Esas son las frases más fundamentales, no voy a decir básicas, fundamentales para que ustedes puedan escribir bien un correo electrónico en inglés. ¿Ok? No básicas, sí, porque no son, no son fáciles.
I have a teacher, hoy varios ya tienen esas palabras, aunque uno no use el inglés, ya automáticamente le dicen attachment o le dicen.
Ajá. En el correo siempre la ven encontrar. Si usted pone su correo en inglés, ya la va a encontrar ahí. Correcto.
A veces ahí, ahí se encuentra.
Exactly. Very good, Sandra. Now, let's continue with the next activity. And I want you
I have a question.
Yes.
For example, if you have any question, please don't hesitate to contact me. Or if you have any question, please don't hesitate to ask me.
To ask me is not common. People will understand better if you say contact me. Because in this case, you are using your email as a way of communication. Right? So the only way they will ask you is through the email. So they need to contact you first.
Okay.
So contact is the best way. Thank you, Carmen. Good question. Any other question right now? Can I continue? Continuamos? Seguimos.
Okay.
Let's continue. Let's continue. Let's continue then. Let's talk. Let's talk right now. I have a question for you. What activities do secretaries do in your company? Let's think about the secretaries in our companies. What do they do every day? What do they do in your company? Or maybe are you a secretary? Right? If you are a secretary, what do you do every day? Right? We need to think about the activities right now. In this question, I am asking you right now to think about three different activities. For example, in my company, Inglés Corporativo, where I work, the secretaries first, one thing that they do is that they type emails and send the emails to the students. That's one thing they do. The second thing they do is that they call students so they can study with us. They can be our students. Another thing that they do, number three, is that they send WhatsApp messages to students, right? Those are activities in my company for the secretaries. No actividades que yo hago, actividades que hacen las secretarias, right? There are like 5-10 secretaries here, men and women. Eso es para hombres y mujeres, secretarios, right? This is what we do. Right? These are the activities. Now, what you have to do right now is to think about the activities that the secretaries do in your company. Vamos a pensar en actividades que las secretarias hacen en su compañía. And we're going to talk about that with our classmates. Va a ser una actividad, un speaking, una práctica de speaking por unos cuantos momentos, unos par de minutos con otros compañeros, ¿ok? ¿Se entiende de qué estamos hablando? ¿Qué tipo de preguntas estamos haciendo? What activities do secretaries do in your company? ¿Se entiende esa pregunta?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, very good. What about the others? ¿Se entiende lo que vamos a trabajar?
Yes, teacher.
Yes?
Yes, teacher.
Yes? Okay, very good.
Yes,
Let's
teacher.
Go ahead and practice them. We're going to practice just for a few minutes. Give me 1 second. We're going to practice as triads right now. So please click on your group right now. Click on your group. Click on your group. Click, 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 click. Click on your group, Daniel, Josué, Roxana, Angie, Celia. Celia. Click on your group. Celia, Roxana. Any questions right now? We have another student.
Siempre se viene a poner aquí.
No, acá solamente vamos a poner las actividades de las secretarias.
Sí, speaking only. Compartan qué hacen las secretarias en sus compañías. That's it. Mm-hmm. Any questions?
Solo vamos a hacer diferentes actividades que ellas hacen.
Sí, solo es. Speaking only. Okay, see you in a moment.
I work. But they usually wear a report and send an email address.
And what about you, Jennifer?
No sé si me logro entender.
Yes.
Again, and
don't have secretaries.
Yes. Entonces, invéntese lo que podría hacer la secretaria. Abigail?
Daily reports? Daily reports?
Okay. They write daily reports? They write daily reports? Okay. What else?
Organize meetings.
Yes. Secretaries organize meetings. Very good. Very good, Daniel. Organize meetings. Repeat.
Organize meetings.
Exactly. Very good. Very good. Okay, I will let you work for a moment. I'll be back with you.
Appointments.
Programar cita, lo voy a buscar. Pero...
Hello, any questions?
¿Cómo pronunciaría pronunciar citas?
Appointments.
Programar citas.
Make appointments.
Make
appointments. No, no es hacer, es programar. Agendar, make appointments. Make appointments es agendar.
Y choose, me parece que entra el doctor. Schedule appointments, ¿qué sería?
Schedule appointments. Schedule appointments, okay, esa es otra forma. Recuérdense que no, en inglés no solo hay una forma de decir las cosas. Schedule appointments is another way. Schedule, se lo voy a escribir acá.
Acá lo tenemos en el chat.
¿Ya lo tiene en el chat?
Sí.
Schedule, ok.
Sí.
Si les cuesta decir schedule, solo digan make appointments.
May appointment. Okay. Schedule.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome.
Podríamos vamos a ver otra
¿dónde la va? ¿Cómo ordenar archivos o organizar archivos sería
también está checks innovation, como chequear facturas.
Check invoices.
Very good. Facturas.
Revisar facturas.
Y también write memos, me parece que se dice.
Write memos, exactly. Write memos
file is... Crime. El otro creo que, si no me equivoco, es call.
Call. Man. Repeat. Call.
Call. Ese es para llamada, client. ¿Verdad? Client. Clients, con ese al final, clients.
Exactly. Call clients.
Sí, verdad.
And write memos.
Call clients.
Escríbaselos ahí en el chat para que ellas lo tengan también, las que está diciendo. Y después las vamos a compartir
ya las puse.
Ok. Call clients, write memos.
Call clients.
Bueno, que ahora ya nos...
Check invoices.
Ahora ya no hacen tanto write memos, sino que type memos. Type in the computer.
Type memos.
Type memos.
Escribir. Type. Sería, si no me equivoco.
Digitar. Type es digitar. En la computadora. Ahí se los acabo de poner. Porque write memos, antes las secretarias lo hacían a mano, o ya no lo hacen a mano, y lo hacen a computador. Entonces, they type memos, they type letters, they type reports. Okay?
Type memo es digital.
Teacher.
Type es digital. Memos es memorándum.
Y cuando ellas, okay. Teacher, cuando ajá. ellas organizan como unos domicilios o como rutas, ¿cómo sería? Organization route.
Organize.
Sí.
Organize routes. Organize routes. Ahí está en el chat. ¿Lo pueden ver?
Yes.
Okay. Very good. So let me continue here. We're going to go, ya tienen bastantes. Vámonos con todos los demás. Let's go. Okay, so we're going to continue right now and we're going to listen to some of the activities that you share with your classmates, okay? Let's go ahead and do those activities, okay? What activities do secretaries do in your company, Carmen?
Well, in my company, the secretary makes phone calls, attend to visitors, and organize meetings too.
Okay, very good. Makes phone calls, organize meetings. Very good. Oops, sorry, meetings. Very good. Thank you, Carmen. Ana Gabriela, what do secretaries do in your company?
Well, answer the phone.
They answer the phone, okay.
Receives correspondence.
Receive correspondence, okay.
Receive. Archive documents.
Okay, receive mail, okay. And what do you say?
Archive documents.
Oh, file.
Archive documents.
Okay, we're going to say file documents. File documents. File documents. Okay. Receive mail, file documents. Very good, Ana Gabriela. Look at the chat, because in the chat I'm putting the phrases that we can use. Puede que sean frases que ustedes también o actividades que ustedes también tengan que hacer. Right? Let's see, Luis Armando. What do secretaries do in your company?
Hi, son lo mismo de, que acaba de mencionar, yo en el grupo de ella. Receive document, answer phone call, archive document, attend visits.
Attend visits. Thank you so much. Attend guests. Okay. Attend guests. Okay, very good. Attend guests. Very good. Now tell me here. Let's go ahead and see one more. Josue, what do secretaries do in your company?
Okay, she controls voucher and delivery of basic food basket, receive stationery, print report.
Receive reports, okay. Deliver basic basket. What is basic basket? Canastas de la comida.
Básicas.
Ajá, bueno. Uy, no copien eso. Deliver basic basket. No, no copien eso. Deliver. Free groceries. Free groceries. Deliver free groceries. Groceries. Son todas aquellas cosas que nosotros vamos al supermercado a comprar para comer. Groceries. Okay. Groceries. No son groserías, son groceries. Groceries. Deliver free groceries. Okay? Because okay. Basic baskets would be correct, but that would be a literal translation. Mm-hmm. Sería una traducción literal. Sí se entiende. Pero deberíamos decir deliver free groceries. Sí son gratis. ¿Son gratis? Gratis. Sí. Entre comillas. Mm-hmm. Okay. Entre comillas. Okay, good. Thank you so much, Josue. Who else? One more. Ricardo, you have like 5. Tell me yours. Ricardo Alexis.
Teacher, call clients.
Call clients. Uh-huh.
Type memo.
Type memos, okay, very
type
good.
Type memos, organize route.
Organize routes, okay.
Route.
Organize routes, very good. What else? You told me another one.
¿No más?
Yes, ¿ustedes tenían otra más?
Yes.
Una difícil tenían.
Checks, invoices.
Check invoices, very good. Check invoices. Cuando ellas como que fueran contadoras, they have to check invoices. Ellas verifican las facturas. Right? They check invoices.
Yes.
There was another one, yes. Celia. You gave me, thank you, Ricardo. You gave me another one, Celia, for appointment. What was the one that you gave me? Copien las frases, por favor. Copien las frases.
Teacher, for example, makes extra hours reports.
Okay, make extra hours. Make overtime.
Overtime.
Make overtime. Overtime, horas extras. Make overtime. Horas extras. Celia, la frase que me dijo. ¿Que a usted le gusta porque es difícil?
Hasta se me olvidó. Schedule appointment.
Schedule appointments,
correcto.
Okay, schedule appointments. ¿Qué era schedule appointments, Angie? Angie y la Celia andan inventando una frase rara. Angie? What is a schedule appointment?
Yes, teacher. Vamos a ver.
You told me what a schedule appointments were.
Programar citas.
Exactly. No, very good. Very good. Programar
sí.
Agendar. Right? Agendar. That's what they do. They schedule appointments. Please repeat with me. Schedule.
Schedule.
Very good, Carmen. That's perfect. Schedule.
Schedule.
Very good. Schedule. Luis, repeat with me. Schedule.
Schedule.
Very good. Daniel, schedule.
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 Very good. Sandra? Pronunciation, Sandra? Sandra.
Schedule.
Very good. Very good. Now, those are the activities that a secretary do. Okay? Remember, those activities, you can maybe use them for you. Do you do any of those activities? ¿Hacen ustedes alguna de esas actividades? Yes, in my case, yes. I schedule appointments with the parents and with the students. Right?
Es mucho más.
Okay, overtime. You do overtime.
Todas make esas overtime. Que están escritas aquí, allí y muchas más.
Y otras más. Okay, very good. So, let's go ahead and continue. Look at this. We're going to practice with a conversation here. Can you look at my computer? This is on page 11 on your book. Luis Armando, can you please read the instruction? Listen to your teacher.
Okay.
Read, please.
Listen to your teacher read the conversation. The upper Y and classmate circle the word that do you not know.
Very good, very good. So you're going to listen to me, read the conversation, okay? And then you're going to practice with another classmate. But you are going to circle the words that you don't know. Si no conocen una palabra que es totalmente extraña para ustedes, right? You're going to circle that word. What does it mean, circle? Right? Circle means to do the following. You're going to go ahead and do this. Circle, 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 right? That's what we're going to do. Now, listen to me, please. Sonia and Matt. We have Sonia and Matt. What does Dominic do? Well, she's a secretary. Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly? Oh, I see your point. Well, she types reports and sends emails every day. She's a hardworking woman. Absolutely. Does she arrive early? Yeah, she's the first person to arrive in the office. Okay, one more time. And pay attention to the intonation. Pongan atención a la entonación, que eso es lo que van a practicar. No solamente la pronunciación, okay? What does Dominique do? Well, she is a secretary. Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly? Oh, I see your point. Well, she types reports and sends emails every day. She is a hardworking woman. Absolutely. Does she arrive early? Yeah. She's the first person to arrive in the office. Okay? Now, we're going to practice that conversation with another classmate. Okay? Very easy. Practice the intonation. No solamente la pronunciación. Podemos tener una pronunciación hermosa. Pero si no hacemos la entonación correcta, no nos van a entender en inglés. Okay? We have to do. Pronunciación es cómo decimos las palabras. ¿Ok? Yo puedo decir, well, she is a secretary. Mi pronunciación es perfecta. ¿Right? Pero si yo, well, she is a secretary, estoy dando la entonación a lo que digo. ¿Ok? So let's practice. We're going to work in pairs right now. Let me put you in groups. You have this conversation on your book, okay? No necesitan tomarle screenshot porque ya la tienen en la página 11. We're going to work in groups and we're going to work in pairs. Let's see here. Solo hay un grupo de tres, de ahí todos los demás van in pairs. So let's go. Let's go right now. Please select your groups. We're gonna practice for 6 minutes and then we come back. Okay? Let's go. Let's practice. Josué, choose your group. Roxana, Angie, choose your groups.
Juan José, no sé si le gustaría ser mat ahorita.
Sí, le gustaría.
Okay. Y María va a ser Sonia.
Es que Galán ya le está repartiendo los puestos.
Exacto.
Hello.
Hello. Hi. Let me listen to you. Josué y María.
Okay. What does Dominic do?
Well, she is a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day except?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she types, reports, and sends email every day. She is a hardworking woman.
Exactly. Come on, teacher.
Okay. What is the word?
Exactly or absolutely?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah, she is the first person to arrive in the office.
Okay, más emoción, José. No le van a entender.
Okay.
You can do it. Oh.
¿Quién la quiere pasar conmigo?
Emerson, what does Dominic do?
Well, she is a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she types report and sends emails every day. She is a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah, she is the first person to arrive in the office.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Sería.
Keep working. Practice your pronunciation and intonation, Emerson.
Okay.
Does she arrive early.
Yeah, arrive. She's the five.
Arrive.
Yeah, she's the first person to arrive in the office.
Okay.
Teacher.
Repeat with me, Angie. First.
Uh-huh.
She is the first person.
She is the first person.
First.
Yes. Teacher, to arrive. Arrive. Así es.
Arrive. Sí.
Arrive in the office. Esta otra también, absolutely. ¿Cómo se pronuncia?
Hay una sílaba que no se pronuncia. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Exacto. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Exacto. Entonces, exacto. Sí. Tenemos la palabra acá. Mire, en la pantalla.
Ajá.
Tenemos absolutely. ¿Ya?
Ok.
Entonces, ¿qué vamos a pronunciar? Absolutely. Esta E se nos va. Absolutely.
Thank you, teacher. Absolutely.
Okay. Absolutely. You. You're welcome.
Teacher, hay otra palabra en hardworking.
Hardworking.
Sí,
así. Hardworking es alguien así como nosotras, que solo trabajando vive.
Okay, teacher.
Hardworking woman.
Hardworking. Absolutely. Okay.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Okay. Y exactly. Exactly.
Exactly. Exactly. Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
Exactly. Exactly.
Digan la conversación, quiero escucharlas.
Okay.
Vaya niña Sandra, yo, ¿verdad? What does Dominic do?
Well, she's a secretary.
Oh, I see you. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she types reports and sends emails every day. She's a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early? Ah, esta otra dice.
Early. Does she arrive early?
Does she arrive early?
Yeah, she's the first person to arrive in the office.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Cambiamos, niña Sandra.
Very Obviously, good.
Niña Sonia, yo en Max.
I see you in a moment.
Okay.
La otra que sería.
Let me listen to your conversation, please.
Okay, yo soy Sofía. What does Dominican do?
Well, she is a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Where she takes report and send every day. She's a hardworking woman.
Okay.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah, she stay first to arrive in a office.
Okay. I need you to repeat with me, please, Pedrina, right?
Yes.
I need you to go ahead and work with me so you can take a look at this, okay? Let's go ahead and repeat, okay? You too, Celia.
Okay.
Okay, we have, what does Dominic do?
What does Dominic do?
Okay, what does Dominic do?
What does Dominic do?
Well, she is a secretary.
Well, she is a secretary.
Very good. Oh, I see.
Oh, I see.
What does she do every day?
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 She.
She.
Do. Está diciendo zapato. Shoe es zapato.
Sí, sí, sí. Okay. She.
What she. Does she do every day?
What does she do every day?
Ok. Tratemos de unir las palabras, Pedrina, porque le está diciendo what does she do every day. Sí. Únalas. Sí. Okay. What, una. Sí. What does she do?
What does she do every day?
Ah, mire qué bonito. Okay. ¿Escuchó, Celia? ¿Escucha la diferencia?
Yes, okay. Yes.
What does she do every day exactly?
What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point.
Oh, I see your point.
I see your point.
I see your point.
Yeah, ya ve. Well, she types reports and sends emails every day.
Where she types reports and sends emails every day.
Sends emails every day.
Send email every day.
She is a hardworking woman.
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 Okay. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Does she arrive early?
Does she arrive early?
Okay. Does she arrive early?
Does she arrive early?
Okay. Early. Vamos a trabajar bastante con la letra R. Okay. R. En inglés. Porque en español decimos ferrocarril, barril, Puerto Rico, right? But in English, we're going to say arrive. ¿Ya han visto los zombies en las películas? ¿Ya han visto los zombies en las películas? Los zombies le hacen lo mismo. Arrive.
Arrive.
Es una R suavecita que casi no se escucha. Arrive.
Arrive.
Ok. Quítele cuando estamos aprendiendo a decir la R, decimos arrive. No. Arrive.
Arrive.
Desenrolle la lengua cuando
arrive.
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 Does she arrive?
Or... She arrive.
Yes. She is the first person to arrive in the office.
Yeah. She is the first person. To arrive in
arrive in the office.
In the office.
Very good. Arrive. Let's go. Porque ya no están esperando todos los demás. Vamos, vamos, chicas. Let's go. Vamos, let's go. First group that I would like to hear is Carmen and Daniel. Carmen and Daniel Amilcar. We want to listen to you guys. Then we were going to listen to Angie and Sandra. And then we're going to listen to Luis Armando. Who was with you, Luis Armando? Who was with you?
Okay.
¿Quién estaba con usted?
Sí, Sandra era.
No, Sandra estaba con Angie.
Conmigo, amiga Sandra.
Okay. No, ya me confundí.
¿Ya se me con la Sandra? Ok, ¿con quién estaba con Luis?
Yo.
Ok, Roxana y Luis. Ok, Roxana Mejibar, Luis Armando, Roxana. Ok, let's start. Carmen and Daniel. Let's listen to you guys.
Ok. Let's start. What does Dominic do?
Daniel, are you there?
Well, she is a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, She types report. I send email every day. She is a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. You're right, Billy.
Yeah, she's the first person to arrive in the office.
Okay, very good. You did a great job. Very good. Very good. After the whole conversations, we're going to see some vocabulary, okay? Let's see Angie and Sandra.
Okay. What does Dominic do?
Well, she's a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she types reports and sends emails every day. She is a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah. She is the first person to arrive in the office.
Very good. Thank you. Very good job. You did great. Excellent. Let's listen to Luis and Roxana.
Okay, teacher.
Ready? Is ready?
Ready.
What does Dominic do?
Well, she is a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she types, report, and sends email every day. She is a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah. She is the first person to arrive in the office.
Very good. You did good. Thank you so much, Roxana and Luis. Very good. Ricardo, who was your partner? Ricardo Alexi Fuentes.
Yes, teacher.
Who was your partner?
Present.
Okay, with Azalea. Okay, let's practice.
Cualquiera.
Yes, you decide. Ustedes practicaron, ustedes digan.
Richard, es que lo practicamos ambos. Richard. Okay.
Inicia usted, Melanie.
Okay. What does Dominic do?
Well, she is a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see you point. Well, she tap report and say email every day. She is a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah, she is the first person to arrive in the office.
Very good. You did good also. Very good. Any volunteers? Anybody else that wants to participate in practice? Josue?
Yeah.
Okay, Josue and Emerson. Thank you. Okay.
Emerson, what does Dominic do?
Well, she is a secretary.
Oh, I see. What does she do every day exactly?
Oh, I see your point. Well, she types report and send emails every day. She's a hardworking woman.
Absolutely. Does she arrive early?
Yeah. She's the first person to arrive in the office.
Okay, very good, very good. So here, I want you to answer right now. What are the words that you didn't know? Words that you didn't know. Tell me one word that you didn't know, Celia Jasmine. Celia Jasmine, you're frozen. Celia, Okay, Luis Armando, tell me one word that you didn't know.
Okay.
Una palabra que no conocía y ahora conoce.
Es hard working, hasta me cuesta pronunciarla.
Hard working. Very good. Repeat with me. Hard working.
Hard working.
Very good. Hard working. Excellent. What's another phrase that you didn't know? Hard working. Do you know what hard working means? ¿Saben qué significa hard working? A person who works a lot. That means hard working.
Trabajadora.
Exactly. Trabajadora. Pero trabajadora de verdad.
Exactly. Absolutamente.
Absolutely, yes. Absolutely. Very good. What's another word that you didn't know, Carmen?
I don't have any other word.
You don't have any. Okay, okay. Concepcion, what's another word that you didn't know? María Concepción. María Concepción.
Hello, teacher.
Any word that you didn't know?
First.
Okay. First. We remember we have first, second, third, right? We have first, número uno, número dos, primero, segundo, first, second, third, fourth. Okay, very good. Abigail, what are some words that you didn't know? Which one, Abigail? Write it in the chat. Write it in the chat, okay? Very good. Now, Celia, are you ready? What are the words that you didn't know, Celia?
Point.
I see your point. Ajá. I see. Esa es una frase. I see your point. Ah, ya te entiendo. Ya te entendí. I see your point. Ah, ya entendí tu punto de vista. I see your point. Ya te entendí. Okay. I see your point. Very good. Now, let's go ahead and practice. This is from module one. Okay. This is from module one. This is grammar. Okay. In grammar, we need to practice with grammar with the simple present statements, okay? With simple present, remember that we use the simple present to talk about daily activities or activities that we do every day, right? That's when we use the simple present. And we also do this to talk about scheduled events, things that we know that are going to happen. For example, I teach English at 8 p.m. Right? I finish my classes at 10 p.m. I take attendance at 9 p.m. Those are activities that I do every day, but I know that they have a specific time in life, right, to complete. So what do we do for the simple present? Remember, with the simple present, this is just a refresher from the module one. We're going to have subject, verb, complement, right? That's the first thing that we need to remember. Now with the subject, verb, and complement, with the simple present, let me show you here in one moment. Right? With the simple present statements, first, you need to remember to use it for daily activities. Right. And also for scheduled activities, right? Actividades que ya agendaron. Schedule activities. Right, that's what I'm going to use this for. Now.
Teacher, routines.
Yes, daily activities are routines. Very good. Daily activities are routines. Otra forma de llamarlas. Very good. Routines or daily activities. Right? Oops, sorry. Very good. Now. Routines. Now, what do we need to remember? Specific things that we need to remember about simple present is when we make questions, what are the subject pronouns that I mentioned yesterday in the class? I mentioned some subject pronouns. What are they? Okay, I. Very good. I.
She, he, it.
I, you.
We, you, they.
Okay, he, she, it, they, and we. Very good. And you again, right? These are the subjects that we're going to use. Now, with the simple present, we can create sentences for activities that we do every day. For example, I take a shower every day, right? That could be a sentence that we can complete with no problem. I take a shower every day. How can I make this sentence if I put here, I take a shower every day at 6 a.m. That is my sentence, right? That is my sentence. I take a shower at 6 a.m. every day. I want you to use she to make the same sentence, use the same elements.
She takes,
okay, she takes a shower.
A shower every day at 6 a.m.
At 6 a.m. At 6 a.m. Very good. At 6 a.m. I want you to make this question, this sentence, she takes a shower at 6 a.m., make it a question.
Does she?
Go ahead.
Does she take a shower at
6 a.m.? A shower at 6 a.m.?
Question mark.
And the question mark, very good. Mm-hmm. I'm glad you remember the question mark. What is a possible short answer?
Yes, she does.
Yes, she does. Very good. Yes, she does. Or?
No, she doesn't.
No, she doesn't. Very good. Excellent job. No, she doesn't. Remember that we also have do and does, right? If I want to make a question with do, right? We can say, do you take a shower at 6 a.m.?
Yes.
Okay, yes, okay. What is the answer? Short answer.
Yes, I do.
Yes, I do, excellent.
Very no, I don't. Simple.
Or yes, I do, or no, I don't. Very good. Yes, I do. No, I don't. Very good. This is the refresher for the simple present. Remember, it's used for daily activities and schedule activities, right? Now, do we understand this part? Do you have questions right now? ¿Alguna pregunta? ¿Alguna pregunta? ¿Alguna pregunta? Ok, me doy por enterada que no tienen preguntas. Can I erase this? ¿Puedo borrar esto?
Yes, you can.
Ok. Ok, very good.
Teacher, un moment, please.
Ya lo borré. Ya, yes. Oh, ahí sí, ya lo borré, sí, ahí sí, ya no puedo recuperarlo.
Ok.
Okay, now we're going to go ahead and work here. I have one small exercise for you. That, oh, this picture looks very bad.
I'm sorry, teacher.
question.
Yes, what's your question?
Yes, if you explain us about the platform.
Oh yes, absolutely, absolutely. You're so right. First, let me put here, because tomorrow I want you to complete this exercise. Okay, let me put this exercise first so you can take a screenshot, and then yes, I will need to explain about the platform. Okay, we're going to do this exercise. Sorry for the, I don't know why the picture looks like this. Can you read the picture? Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Let me put it here. We're going to complete these simple present statements, right? Using simple present, of course, no, mm-hmm. Okay? We're going to use simple present. We have already the verbs there, and these are only present statements. There are no questions, there are no answers, only sentences. But you have different subjects, so I need you to pay attention. You also have different verbs. Busquen las palabras que no conocen, así ampliamos el vocabulario, okay? So, please take a screenshot.
Yes, teacher, I'll see.
Okay. Okay, very good.
Hey, wait.
Okay, let me put it one more time. Ese sí está disponible. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, thank okay. you.
You're welcome. Now, I am going to explain to you the platform. What do we do in the platform? And I want you to pay attention to this, please. Give me one moment, I just need to access to the platform. Okay. We're going to do this explanation in Spanish para que todos entendamos qué es lo que se debe hacer en la plataforma. ¿Pueden ver mi pantalla? ¿Sí?
Yes.
Ok.
Yes.
Chivo, chivo, chivo. Entonces tenemos acá la plataforma. Esta es la plataforma de inglés corporativo. Todos, para el día de hoy, todos tienen que tener acceso a la plataforma. Si no tienen acceso, escríbanlo en el chat para si yo tomo notas y les digo a los administradores. ¿Qué hay que hacer en la plataforma? Tenemos en la plataforma, bueno, esa es la mía, ¿verdad? Pero vamos a ver acá. Hay cuatro secciones para el inglés principiante módulo 2. La sección 1 es la que estamos en estos momentos. Entonces nosotros nos vamos a ir a la sección 1, donde dice Unit 1, Work Related Events, ¿verdad? Nos vamos para la sección 1. Y en la sección 1, perdón, dice acá. Lo primero que vamos a encontrar en la sección 1 dice videoconferencia número 1, simple present statements. Esa es la clase de ayer. Para los que no estuvieron en la clase de ayer, por ejemplo, ayer no estuvo... Creo que Ana Gabriela no estuvo ayer. Ana Gabriela, usted tiene la opción, y esto es opcional, pero es lo mejor que deberían de ser. Como ella no estuvo en la clase, usted puede ver el video de la clase de ayer. Esto se publica en esta plataforma, es accesible para todos. También está en YouTube, ¿verdad? Pero si usted va a la plataforma, ahí lo va a encontrar sin ningún problema. Lo único que no lo busque a las 6 de la mañana, ¿verdad? Del día siguiente. Lo va a encontrar a partir de las 10 de la mañana en adelante. Si usted no lo encuentra, me avisa y revisamos con los administradores a ver qué ha sucedido. Pero ahí usted va a tener acceso para que, o si no entendió algo, o se quiere recordar de algo. O por ejemplo, Angie, que no tomó el screenshot de lo que hicimos hoy, mañana puede ir otra vez y ir a la pantalla a tomar solamente ese screenshot. Para eso sirven estos videos. You're welcome. Ahora, ¿qué va a haber acá? Por ejemplo, acá abajo del video hay una parte que dice discusión. Generalmente en la semana tratamos de poner discusiones de las actividades que hacemos durante la clase. Por ejemplo, hoy, que ya terminamos el día 2, mañana va a aparecer el video acá. Dice videoconferencia número 2, time expressions for regular activities. Este es mi jefe. Ahorita le aparece porque tiene que aparecer. Pero mañana va a aparecer el video de nosotros. Lo que estamos grabando en estos momentos va a aparecer mañana. Acá abajo va a aparecer una tarea que ustedes tienen que compartir. Yo agrego acá la tarea, ustedes van a revisar la plataforma y van a ir a interactuar, en la plataforma para reforzar inglés. O si tienen alguna pregunta ahí la pueden poner también, pero lo más recomendable para preguntas es el chat, ¿verdad? Que tenemos. Ahora, ¿qué pasa acá? Tenemos la videoconferencia de ayer, videoconferencia número 1. Cuando usted ya ha pasado acá, se va a la segunda parte que dice tarea número 1. En la tarea número 1 ya tenemos acá una tarea que es bien fácil, solamente son 5 preguntas, ¿verdad? 5 statements que usted tiene que compartir. Estas son 5 tareas a la semana que van a encontrar. Unos estudiantes me preguntan, ¿las puedo terminar ya todas? Sí, si usted cree que es capaz de terminarlas todas, las puede terminar todas, no hay ningún problema. Si usted en dado caso, por ejemplo, acá ustedes pueden ver que dice tarea 0 de 20. Si usted tiene en esta tarea 16, está bien. Si usted tiene 15, tiene que volverla a hacer. Porque en este caso no llegó al mínimo requerido por INSAFOR. ¿Cuál es el mínimo requerido por INSAFOR? 80. En este caso sería un 8.0 o 80 de 100. Usted tiene que volverlo a hacer. Ahora, cuando usted lo termina, acá le tiene que aparecer donde dice submit. En algunos les aparece como enviar. Usted le da enviar y ya eso se guarda automáticamente acá y yo lo puedo ver si usted ya lo terminó. ¿Qué pasa acá? Cuando llegamos a la videoconferencia 5, que sería el viernes, yo estaría revisando todas las tareas de la semana el sábado por la mañana. Si usted no las termina el sábado por la mañana, se puede quedar sin nota. Así que, por favor, termine las de la semana el viernes a más tardar, ¿verdad? O sábado temprano, para que sea a las 12, ya nosotros podamos tener notas. Ahora, esta es la semana 1. En la sección 2 hay algo nuevo. ¿Por qué? Porque ya no solamente tenemos las tareas. Si ustedes se pueden fijar, acá dice section 2. Unit 2, ongoing activities at the workplace. Tenemos todas las 5 actividades de siempre, pero al final tenemos un examen parcial, que es un midterm. Dice 4 preguntas, pero en realidad son 4 partes del examen parcial. Este examen debe estar terminado el viernes, también por la noche, para así poder tener las notas de esta actividad para el sábado, ¿verdad? Eso es con base en lo que han visto en la sección 1. Y la sección 2. Luego vamos con la sección 3. Igual tenemos las mismas actividades. Y al final de la sección 4 se repite como la semana 2. Final exam. Ese es el examen final. Si nosotros terminamos módulo, empezamos módulo el 1 de marzo, estaríamos terminando módulo el 26 de marzo. Para el 25 de marzo ya todos tendrían que haber terminado cada una de las actividades de la plataforma, sin excepción, para así poder enviar todos los documentos a INSAFOR y que ustedes puedan tomar su cupo apartado, el que apartan en la segunda semana y tercera semana, para tomarlo ya para final de curso. Eso es lo que hacemos acá. Entonces, puntos importantes que tenemos que tomar en cuenta son las discusiones y las tareas que ustedes tienen que hacer todas las semanas en la plataforma. Ahorita quisiera saber si todos tienen acceso a la plataforma. ¿Sí?
Yes.
Ok, ¿hay algo que les gustaría que les explique de nuevo, sobre todo a los que se han incorporado en el módulo 2?
Por el momento no, Lick, y si tenemos preguntas, yo lo voy a escribir.
Sí, escríbame ahí en el grupo del WhatsApp. Lo único que durante el día, es muy probable que no le conteste inmediatamente. Lo voy a contestar, pero no inmediatamente, ¿verdad?
Está bien, entonces, no hay problema.
Entonces, Sí, escriba y puede escribir en el grupo del WhatsApp. Si alguien te da la respuesta, muy amablemente se la puede proporcionar también del equipo, sobre todo los que ya estuvieron en el módulo 1. Ahora, esta es la parte donde ustedes van a ver el manual, Students Manual, ustedes lo ven acá, ¿verdad? En este, acá, me comentaban que estaba solamente, sí, tiene 49 páginas, está completo. Está todo el manual del estudiante para que ustedes lo puedan descargar, pero yo creo que ya en este momento todos lo tienen. Gabriela, no sé si usted tiene su manual. Gabriela. Ana. Ana Gabriela.
Sí, teacher. Sí,
con Gaby somos compañeras de trabajo. Y yo se lo compartí este día.
Ah, ok, perfecto. Sí, ¿con quién es compañera de trabajo? Con
Ángel. Celia.
Ah, con no. Celia. Ok, sí, con perfecto, Celia. Perfecto. Entonces, ahí tienen, por si acaso lo iban a perder, de ahí mismo lo pueden descargar sin ningún problema, aquí tienen el botón de descarga, y ustedes pueden ir viendo su progreso también como estudiantes, ustedes lo pueden ir viendo acá donde dice progreso, a mí me dice que no he progresado porque no he hecho nada de la unidad, pero ustedes cuando vayan viendo pueden ir viendo cómo van avanzando en cada una de las secciones, ¿ok? Y cuando no entiendan la plataforma, no puedan acceder, o por ejemplo, digamos, a veces pasan los sistemas que ustedes están haciendo la tarea y hay alguna tarea que ustedes por más que la hacen les está dando error y no saben cómo contestar, le dicen, yo creo que la estoy respondiendo bien y no me deja la plataforma, me la pone mala siempre. Tómele un screenshot, tómele una captura de pantalla y envíemela directamente a mí y yo voy a ver qué es lo que está pasando. A veces lo que sucede es lo siguiente, cuando llenamos estas tareas, sobre todo, permítanme, vamos a ver esta, no, vamos a buscar una donde sea de complementar. Santo Padre, usted solo deja seleccionar esta semana. Permítanme un segundito, chicos. Ya lo voy a dejar ir, permítanme. Pero sí quiero ser bien clara en eso porque nos ha pasado bastante anteriormente. Cuando llenamos la plataforma y llenamos tareas donde ustedes tienen que escribir su respuesta. Cosas que debemos tomar en cuenta cuando escribimos nuestras respuestas es que no debemos dejar espacios al final de la oración que hemos escrito. No, si vamos a escribir una oración, la oración al inicio debe ir con mayúscula y tiene que ir un punto al final de la oración. Si vamos a utilizar, por ejemplo, esta acá que teníamos una vez un problema con Josué, creo, que acá es esta parte, este símbolo que ustedes pueden ver acá, tiene que ser el correcto, ¿verdad? Porque a veces utilizamos otro que no es este, este es el correcto, ¿verdad? Y a veces utilizamos otros que no tienen nada que ver con eso, entonces la plataforma no se los va a leer. No se los va a leer y se lo va a poner como malo. Entonces, cuando a ustedes les llegue a suceder algo así, por favor, me indican a mí. Yo voy a ver qué es lo que han puesto en la imagen. Y con base en lo que han puesto en la imagen, yo les voy a decir, ah, sí, no, hágale este cambio. Hágale eso. No les voy a dar las respuestas de las preguntas, por más que les cueste. Y que ustedes tienen que ir trabajando las respuestas y yo les voy a ir indicando prácticamente cómo ir respondiendo cada una de las preguntas. Ahora, ¿alguna interrogante o pregunta acerca de la plataforma hasta el momento?
No,
no. Okay. No, okay. So let's go ahead. I'm gonna call the attendance porque ya son las 10. Les voy a pasar la asistencia rapidito antes que se me duerman. Por favor, encienda su cámara, Luis Armando y Celia, si no es mucho problema. Daniel, usted también. Paso la asistencia rapidito y ya se pueden ir. Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayoa.
Present.
Very good. Ángela de Jesús Santa María.
Presente, teacher.
Azalia Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Present.
Very good. Carmen Lizette Hernández Escobar. Carmen Lizette.
Present.
Celia Jazmín Castro de Chévez.
Present.
Daniela Milker Sandoval Avilés.
Present.
Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present.
Glenda Esmeralda Trigueros Vázquez. José Alfonso Palma Mejía. Juan Josué Hernández Hernández. Luis Armando.
Present.
Thank you. Leida Susana Sorto Cuadra. Luis Armando Ventura Campos.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. María Concepción Cerón Jovel.
Present,
teacher. Pedrina Iliana Gómez Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ricardo Alexis Fuentes Rodríguez.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Gabriel Alvarenga Ventura. Roxana Yanira Mejíbar Escobar.
Present.
Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Present, teacher.
And Jennifer Abidail López Escoto.
Present, teacher.
Okay, perfect. So that's the attendance for today, guys. Si tienen alguna pregunta acerca de la clase de hoy, por favor me indican mañana. Así la solventamos antes de seguir con la clase de mañana. Okay?
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Have a beautiful night. See you tomorrow.
Good night, teacher.
Good night.
Bye-bye. Good
night,
teacher. Bye.
Good night. Bye-bye. Have a beautiful night.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.